In our previous class, we have discussed about the refraction of light. What is meant by the refraction? Whenever light travels from one medium to another medium, it bends towards the interface of the two mediums. Actually, it is not bending because it changes its velocity. Light changes its velocity when it travels from one medium to another medium. We have seen so many concepts and different experiments in our previous class activities. Let's go through some more activities from this lesson. Okay?
I'll go start.
This is a circular disc. It is movable like this. Here two straws are indicated. I'm keeping this at 0, 0. Two are very straight. This part is immersed in water. Here no deviation is observed. Some deviation, light deviation. Keep these two straws in a straight line way. So here we don't observe any deviation. Nice. Now I am changing this to 10 degrees. Again I am dipping into the water. In water, they are not in straight line. It is not in 10 degrees. Just move like this. It is nearly 12 or 13 degrees. Here, initial angle is, incident angle is 10 degrees. R is 13 degrees. And again I am changing it to 20 degrees. I am also keeping at 20 degrees, but it is not straight. Now I am keeping it as straight line. Observe carefully. It is nearly 25 degrees. Now again observe carefully. I'm keeping at 30 degrees. Also keeping 30 degrees. Dipping in the water. It's not straight. Observe carefully. It is 35 degrees. Now I am keeping it at 40 degrees. Here also 40. It's not straight line. We should observe it as being straight at 42 degrees. Again we are taking 50 degrees. 50 degrees. Not straight. Just observe it as 52 degrees. R is equals to 52 degrees. Similarly, for 60 degrees, is not straight. Is observed that at 65 degrees. So last we'll keep it at 90 degrees. Observe carefully. Here also I'm keeping 90 degrees. Yes, Here, no deviation is observed because they are at same similar level. Both are at same level. For 0 degrees, there is no deviation is observed. And 90 degrees, there is no deviation is observed. Okay. From this, we can conclude that observe carefully. Here, incident angle is less than that of refractive angle. Here, refracted angle is more than refracting angle is greater than incident angle. That means whenever the light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, it is away from the normal. And from this experiment, second observation is refracted angle is more than that of incident angle. And in previous experiment, light travels from rarer to denser. In that situation, incident angle is always more than that of refracted angle. In this situation, denser to rarer, refracted angle is more than that of the incident angle. That means light when it travels from rarer to denser, it is bends towards the normal, and it is when it travels from rarer to denser to rarer, it is away from the normal, and refracted angle is greater than incident angle. Now we are going to learn about Snell's law. According to this, sin A by sin R is equals to N2 by N1, where N is the refractive index of the first medium, N2 is the refractive index of the second medium, I is the incident angle, R is the refracted angle. We know that N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. This is known as Snell's law. Already we know that N2 by N1 is equal to V1 by V2. We derived that one. Equating these two, N1 by N, sin I by sin R is equal to V1 by V2, N2 by N1 is equal to V1 by V2. This is known as Snell's law. That means, whenever the light travels from one medium to another medium, the refractive indexes, ratio of refractive indexes is equal to the ratio of their velocities. Here, whenever the light ray, from these experiments, we can conclude that, here, refracted ray, incident ray and normal always lies in a same plane. Instant ray, normal ray and refracted ray always lies in a same plane. This is first law of refraction. Light ray in refraction always follows Snell's law. That is, N1 sin A is equal to N2 sin R. These two laws are called laws of refraction. Always refracted ray and incident ray, normal, lies in the same plane. And whenever in the refraction, it always follows the Snell's law. Okay, now we'll observe that what happens if the angle of incidence is 90 degrees or more than 90 degrees. Observe carefully. We have done same experiment. Same rubber sheet, semicircular glass slab and circular disc representing angles MM and NM. Now we'll do experiment like this. keeping this glass slab at 9 mm line 1990. Now pass the light ray through 00 on NN. Observe carefully. In this experiment, light is traveling from rarer medium to denser medium. Denser medium to rarer medium. For 0 degrees, there is no deviation. For 10 degrees, it shows 20 degrees deviation. I is equals to 10 degrees, R is equals to 20 degrees. Observe carefully. For 30 degrees, for 20 degrees, it is showing nearly 30 degrees. So, for 30 degrees, it is nearly 40 degrees. For 40 degrees, observe carefully. For 40 degrees, it is nearly 65 degrees. For 50 degrees, in between 50 degrees, there is no emergent ray. It is reflected back to the normal in the same medium. Observe carefully. At 50 degrees, it came back into the same medium. Now we'll see at what angle it passes through the line MM. Observe carefully. Nearly at 42 degrees, it passes through the MM line. If the angle of incidence is increasing, again it comes to the same medium. At some angle, light ray passes through MM line, same line. That means at which angle it refracts back into the same medium is known as, that angle is known as critical angle. The phenomena at critical angle, the light ray back into the same medium, is known as total internal reflection. This is the another beauty of the light. That means whenever the angle of incidence, whenever light ray travels from here, denser medium to rarer medium, the angle of incidence is increasing, then after some time some deviation is observed. After that, again refraction is taken into the same medium. If it is more than 50 degrees, it is observed that again we come back to the same medium, glass slab. So the angle in between 40 and 50 it at some angle it passes the same line, mm line. So that angle is known as critical angle. The phenomenon that light ray passes through the same medium at some particular angle, if the incident angle is going to be increased, this phenomenon is known as total internal reflection. So this angle is critical angle. So sin C is equals to N2 by N1. This is the formula to calculate the sin angle of the total internal reflection. We are going to learn about total internal reflection. For this, before going to know about it, we shall have an activity. Take a coin. I think all of you see the coin. Now I am keeping a glass jar on it and I am moving aside. If I am moving from this, I am unable to see the coin clearly. Now I am pouring some water in it.
Achai.
Whenever I pour the water, I am able to observe the coin in that water surface clearly. This is the beauty of total internal reflection, which has many beauties of total internal reflection in the world. So best example is mirages. Whenever you have traveled in the summer, on the black roads, in some other way, we should observe some water is there. But if you go there, there is no water. If you go there, again you will see, at some distance, you will observe the water. You will observe the water. But again, you have to go there, there is no water. This is an optical illusion. This is known as mirage. How these mirages are formed? Okay, whenever in summers road sun rays are falling, the air near to the road is very hot than that of the air above the road. This is cold air, this is hot air. Hot air is very lighter than cold air. That means light travels more faster in hot air than that of the cold air. That means here hot air is a rarer medium and cold air is a denser medium. That means whenever the light ray comes and hits back and go to the hot air to cold air, we shall see that image of a tree should be seen on the road like water is there. This is known as optical illusion. This is due to total internal reflection, TIR, total internal reflection. This is a beauty of the light. This has many applications, many applications. We know the diamond is very costliest and brightens every time. It is very very bright. Why it is bright means whenever the light ray falls on the diamond, it get me reflected again and reflected. That means total internal reflection was happened in the diamond. Then it is become more brighter. That means to brightness of the diamond was caused by total internal reflection. And another important use, we know that OFC cables, optical fiber cables. We are observing this at on roads. Roads are digging some small wires, less than a wire is like this. In that small wires, small, very very small wires, a bunch of wires is observed. There should be depth in the earth. These are called very 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 low thickness optical fiber cables. We are observing it on the roads, OFC cables, optical fiber cables. This is very very important, because today our classes are going through internet. We are enjoying in this lockdown period our classes through internet, and online classes are going. All these online classes, our internet cables, internet signals should be gone through this optical fiber cables. This is very very important foundation finding of in our life. So these not only used for communication. These are used in treatment of different diseases. So optical fiber cabled light is sent through our body to scan and finding the where the fault is there, where is the problem is identified. And some technology is there, cyber knife technologies, which is used in cancer treatment. A knife is instructing through optical fiber cables to our stomach and identify the problem and remove the cancer's cell and bring back it to the from this cable instruction through the computer. The most relevant and advanced technologies are finding through these optical fiber cables. This is very very important innovation of the 20th century by our scientists. This optical fiber cable is the best innovation in our 20th century. This is very much beauty of the light